What's going on, guys? October 2nd. I was going to film this news update last night, but I'm glad I waited because we had a lot of stuff that happened that we are going to discuss. So this might be a very long video, but there's a lot of great points that you need to know. So first, let's talk about the shooting that occurred last night in Las Vegas. Mainstream media reports are now saying that 50 are dead, multiple hundred people are injured, and what they're saying is that there was a lone gunman shooter that was on the 32nd floor of the Mandalay Bay Resort and Casino. He had upwards of 10 automatic rifles that he began firing from his hotel room at the crowd and killed all these people. Now, here's a lot of other points that, of course, you won't hear in the mainstream media. I got a lot of questions. Now, this, of course, obviously sets off the false flag alarms in my head, and again, this is in combination with the false flag that we saw in Canada just the other day with the ISIS guy stabbing people up in Edmonton. So again, we have multiple terror attacks occur very closely, but there's also a lot of other questions I have in regards to this Las Vegas shooting that I'm going to pose to you right now. So first, how did he get all these guns up into the hotel room? 10 plus automatic rifles up to the 32nd floor. You know, I'm surprised he wasn't on the 33rd floor, if you know what I mean. But 32nd floor, all these automatic rifles. Seems very weird that one guy was able to do that. Now, also, huge blocks in Las Vegas, right? I was just in Las Vegas a couple months ago. I didn't realize that these blocks are like massive. You could go for a 10-minute walk and still not hit the next street. They're a square mile long. So if this guy's up in the 32nd floor shooting down at this festival, I mean, I don't know exactly the logistics or the layout of where he was at, but it's most likely like a half mile shot at least to that festival. So, man, he must have been a real good shot, right? Or he wasn't the only shot. I've had a couple people say to me that there has been reports of multiple shooters, which we often find in these false flag events. So if it looks like a false flag and it smells like a false flag, it's probably a false flag. And point in case as well, with the false flag, because a lot of people get this idea misconstrued, just when the term false flag is used, doesn't mean nobody died. 9/11 was a false flag. Three towers fell. Lots of people died. A false flag simply means that this event that occurred, this tragic, traumatizing event, was done by people other than what was reported for a political or agenda-driven means. That's it. 9/11 was a false flag. Gulf of Tonkin was a false flag. How many of these countless shootings have we had over the past 5 to 10 years? Mainly have all been false flags. Some of them, maybe nobody died, right? The whole Sandy Hook thing, I haven't delved too deep into that, but it's a possibility. But in many of these, yes, people have died. So just want to make that point clear. Next question. Suicide, or did the police kill him? So the first report I read, you know, I read a few mainstream media reports just to kind of nitpick as to the inconsistencies that they usually have with occurrences like this. In one report, I read that the shooter committed suicide, which, typical patsy move when they mind control a guy to go perform one of these atrocities, usually kills himself. But in other reports I've seen from the mainstream media, they said that the police killed him. So again, we have an inconsistency there. I also had somebody send me a picture of a false flag actor that some of the mainstream media news sources interviewed at this Las Vegas scene. And this actor was also found at the Orlando shooting and a couple of the other shootings. So I'll post a screenshot of it here so you can see the woman's face. So we've got conflicting reports of how the dude died, weird occurrences on how he actually killed all those people from so far away, got all those guns up to the window. And lastly, another thing is, what are they trying to distract us from? Crucial point when you're trying to deduce if something is a false flag, what are they trying to distract us from? And we'll get into all the other news stories that they would be trying to distract us from in this instance. And lastly, I want to talk about the astrological component of this, because, you know, as I believe JP Morgan said, millionaires don't use astrology, billionaires do. So these wealthy deep state occultists, you might not understand all the astrological parameters or why they may do things, but it's a very esoteric science, literally as a science, you know, and I don't know too much about astrology in particular, but somebody who does sent me a message, and they made a point that right now Saturn is at 22 degrees in the zodiac. Saturn just happens to be at 22 degrees of Sagittarius. Saturn, which these deep states pray to, right? That's their god that represents their beloved Satan figure. So we have Saturn, which is at 22 degrees in the zodiac. 22 degrees is known as the assassin's degree. Pretty big assassination right there. And Sagittarius, which is the zodiac sign of an archer shooting from a distance. So very important dots to connect. And of course, too, this festival that the shooting occurred at was called the Harvest Festival. So we had Saturn, the occultist god, at the degree known as the assassin's degree, 22 degrees, and Saturn is at 22 degrees of Sagittarius, which is the archer shooting from a distance. Look at all of that occult reference right there. I mean, it's just blatant, and with it being a harvest festival, we know the deep state love human sacrifice when these portals open up. So, boom, there's a bunch of shit that just sets off the false flag, red flags right there. So there's a lot of stuff I wanted to make note of about that. Do your own diligent research so you can get your facts straight, because I've seen a lot of people, they're wondering, a lot of people who are unaware of all this stuff going on, they're like, how can there be so much evil and hatred and stuff going on this world? Well, we need to educate them exactly why this stuff's going on in the world. So there's a bunch of things you can use to do that. Next, let's talk about some of this stuff they're using this to distract us from. So next we have the politically fueled Puerto Rican disaster, and this needs to be cleared up. You know, the mainstream media, of course, is reporting that this Puerto Rican mayor from San Juan is saying the Trump administration's not doing anything, yet she's sitting there with, like, bottles of water and all this stuff behind her, and I don't know how on resource-stricken, no-power Puerto Rico that just got hit by a giant storm does this Puerto Rican mayor of San Juan find time to make a shirt that says, like, help us, we're dying. So it looks like there is a large use of this situation to use it for political and agenda-driven means. From multiple reports, we have reports from a Puerto Rican CEO, we have reports from other mayors in Puerto Rico, and reports from a police officer in Puerto Rico himself. They've all been saying that the American military and the American federal agencies, like FEMA, they've actually all been doing their job above and beyond. They've been doing exactly what they need to do. There's like 10,000 containers that are sitting at a shipment center in Puerto Rico, and it's been blamed in the mainstream media. I saw an article on NPR about this, that these 10,000 container ships were not being distributed around Puerto Rico because of a truckers union strike. But what I really think is going on is that truckers union strike is an excuse, because the local government is so corrupt, like that San Juan mayor I was making a mention of. They're so corrupt and inept that they don't want to move this stuff around Puerto Rico because they want to use this catastrophe. They want to really milk this catastrophe and use it against the Trump administration. So again, it's the local government that's stalling. FEMA seems to be doing its job. And that San Juan mayor wasn't even attending the FEMA meetings. Everybody else was. But she's the one that's blaming Donald Trump. And she actually just, I believe like this morning, said she got off the phone with Senator Elizabeth Warren. So there you go. She gets her marching orders from the shadow government. And then this whole situation that's all fudged up is blamed on Donald Trump. So you can see how all of that misinformation is coming out and things are really going on behind the scenes there. So, but that's getting exposed. Keep in mind, the reason they need this Las Vegas shooting to distract us from that is because A lot of people are figuring out what's really going on in Puerto Rico. They're seeing what's really going on in Spain as well. Next news story. So Catalonia, the region in Spain that borders France, that Barcelona is in, they voted a resounding yes. Like 80 to 90% of people voted yes for independence from Spain. And the Spain federal government tried as hard as they could the past couple days to prevent that vote from happening. I'm sure you've seen the videos of the federal police men who are in like full armor, body gear, and batons trying to prevent people from getting to the polling stations. I think some multiple hundreds of people, I think upwards of 700 people were injured in this whole stuff, all these shenanigans that are going on in Spain. So this is a blatant show of how Western democracy is failing. It's one of the biggest examples of how a globalist empire is absolutely destroying itself and people want out. So Catalonia, which is like, I mean, imagine if Texas legit seceded from America. This is pretty much, you know, it's very similar to that effect. So Catalonia basically seceded from Spain. Huge example of how Western democracies, I don't even want to say democracies because we're not in a democracy, we're in a corporatocracy. So it's a huge example of how these corporatocracies are failing and getting exposed. So of course, the deep state, New World Order, occultists want to distract us with this from not only Puerto Rico, but also what's going on in Spain. And, you know, so that's, there's so much stuff going on the past couple days that's why it took me 12 minutes to describe all of it. And that's basically those three big news stories right there. Now I want to cover just a few things that are under the radar, but I still feel like they're important to make a note of for your awareness. Keep in mind, you know, on the topic of false flags, this could very well be a setup for a future false flag that I want to make you aware of and say right here, because again, if we expose their plans, right, a lot of people are saying, oh, how do we get rid of all this torment, misery, and death? Well, shine a light on it. Be aware of it. Here's a light I want to shine real quick. So the stadium that the Super Bowl is going to be hosted in, U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis, Minnesota, they had a security firm that's been running security for them called Monterey Security. They were only 1 year into a three-year contract, but they were fired just last week. This security firm, Monterey Security, was fired from the U.S. Bank Stadium in Minneapolis. And what firm did they hire instead? GS4. So GS4 is now running security for this stadium, which is going to host the Super Bowl in about 4 months, 5 months here. But I want to make a quick note. What about this GS4 company? Well, the Orlando false flag shooter, remember, opened up in, you know, the Orlando nightclub, killed how many people? He used to work for them. This is a security contractor who that false flag patsy used to work for. So again, on the topic of false flags, I think this could be setting us up for a false flag. Might not be at the Super Bowl, might just be at an event being held at this U.S. Bank Stadium, you know, but I don't want to put any fear porn out there. I just want to make you aware if something happens here, we already have a doc to connect with it. So there's that. We have another murdered doctor to add to the 100 plus. Again, I've reported on this before. If you don't know about it, please go do some research about it. Dr. Mercola's wife, Erin Elizabeth, has done fantastic reporting on it. I have mentioned it in other videos, and I also mentioned it discussed it a little more in depth on day two of my Eclipse of Disclosure presentations. You can track back through my previous videos from a few weeks ago where I discussed a little more in depth about it. We have all these murdered holistic doctors, many of them delving into natural cancer therapies and vaccine truths. This guy was found, his body, he was about a 70-year-old doctor. His name was Dr. Peter Cianfrani, if I'm saying that right. He was 70 years old. He was discovered in a wooded area. He was found dead on a trail near Pennsylvania. Just want to make a note of that. I don't know exactly why he may have been on the radar, if this is a form of a suicide, but, or, you know, a mysterious death. But it was noted that he might have been an anti-vaccine doctor, so some of his patients have said that he was pretty adamant about not getting shots. So that could be a reason if there are mysterious circumstances surrounding this death as to why it could have happened. A new police report has come out describing how former UK Prime Minister Sir Edward Heath, I don't believe that he deserves to be called Sir, so I'm just going to call him Ted. A new police report came out describing how detailing 42 assault claims, with few of them being rape of underage males. And two cases linked to the ex-premier's interest in sailing. So, unfortunately, this guy is dead. He died in 2005. But police reports are now coming out detailing how this guy had abused children. And I think we're going to see a lot more of these reports coming out. Of course, it'd be very difficult for police reports to be naming people that are alive who abuse children and are into this stuff. So I think they're starting with people who are dead already to show the mass population that it is a very real thing and it exists. It's not so traumatizing when you think of people who are already dead who are into this stuff. And I think as these police precincts are freed up to do more of their job, more work, as they're able to do more investigations into pedophilia and trafficking and whatnot, we'll see more of this stuff come out because as I've heard in America here, we've had how many thousands of people arrested this year because of human trafficking. So, of course, it needs to be known and exposed that the people at top of the political chain do this stuff, and they do much worse than just abuse a child here and there. I mean, it's sacrificial of what they do. But what's going on is that all the local precincts, they're getting freed up to actually do their jobs because in the past we've had governments in place that would stifle any investigations that began. So not as many of these investigations are getting stifled because this current administration is more, more open to this. They're trying to get rid of it. So I think we'll see more of these come out. And then lastly, I want to make a note of these mysterious towers that are going up in New York. A couple people have sent me this article. It's just weird. We have a bunch of metal towers popping up in tunnels and on bridges in New York. People who own these towers won't comment. There's no information coming out about them. But of course, when we're putting two and two and two and two together, it's probably because New York being like Gotham City, I mean, they're trying to install the technologies in place in case they were to call martial law. Then they have their facial recognition and whatever the hell are in these towers. It's probably all people watching stuff, AI, who knows what kind of artificial intelligence or cameras they may very well be in this, or some kind of other populace watching technologies. But again, don't be scared by this because if this is being created by nefarious means, doesn't mean that there's a chance that some white hats or some alliance forces will use this technology and turn it on the bad guys, right? Because let's be real, the so-called alliance can use a lot of these NSA and human tracking technologies against the people that created them, if they were to get their hands on them. So that's just a point I want you to make. No fear porn, again, no fear porn associated with a lot of these stories. I just want you to be aware. And the more awareness that we have, the more positive that I get, because then people are getting it. They're sharing the truth with their friends and family. And that's why the deep state has to take such drastic measures to do shit like this. Worst mass shooting in American history is because so many people are waking up. And so much stuff is going on. So anyway, that's my news report for today, October 2nd. Thank you all for all of your support on Patreon, with PayPal, with sending me articles and sharing these videos and everything that you guys do to help me continue doing this stuff. Done.